Namaskar, I'm Suruchi Das and you're watching Rhythm News. In a recent podcast with Pakistani YouTuber, fugitive preacher Zakir Nayak made a series of baseless claims against the Indian government. Living in exile in Malaysia after facing charges of radicalizing youth and spreading hatred, Nayak's attempt to portray himself as a victim is a calculated effort to mislead the public and sow discord within India. The most outrageous of his claims was that a representative of Prime Minister Narendra Modi met him in 2019 before the abrogation of Article 370, inviting him to return to India. If this were true, why would the Indian government later declare him a fugitive and charge him with links to terrorist organizations? The Indian government under PM Modi has always maintained a firm stance against terrorism, making Nayak's statement only improbable but also a transparent attempt to malign the administration. Nayak further accused the government of plotting to seize properties held by the Waqf Board, the controversial land-owning body in India. He twisted facts to incite fear within the Muslim community, falsely claiming that the Modi government sought to amend the Waqf Act for nefarious purposes. In reality, the Indian constitution protects religious rights and there are no government plans to illegally take over Waqf properties. By spreading such misinformation, Nayak is attempting to manipulate public opinion and create unnecessary division. His attack on the Indian government's decision to abrogate Article 370, which integrated Kashmir fully into India, reveals his anti-national sentiments. The move, widely recognized as a step towards securing India's unity and sovereignty, was portrayed by Nayak as unconstitutional, further demonstrating his hostility towards India's democratic processes. Zakir Nayak's history of inciting violence through his sermons, pushing radical ideologies and influencing vulnerable youth to join extremist groups stands in stark contrast to his self-portrayal as a preacher of peace. His inflammatory speeches, banned in several countries, have only increased religious tension. His recent podcast is yet another example of his dangerous agenda. Furthermore, Nayak's ties to the Congress Party have also raised eyebrows. In 2010, he made a significant donation to Rajiv Gandhi Trust, an association that has drawn criticism and questions about the Congress Party's links to controversial figures like Nayak. His remarks hinting that he could return to India if another government came to power suggests that he may still harbor hopes for political support in the future, adding to the speculation surrounding his connection with Congress. Zakir Nayak's deliberate misinformation campaign against India, particularly against the Modi government, is an attempt to incite communal disharmony and destabilize national unity. His allegations are not only baseless, but reveal his true intention to drive a wedge between communities, tarnish India's global image, and provoke unrest. Jai Hind.